Now let us see that how we have got this value of g, and from this value of g we'll understand that on what factors actually it depends. Okay, so let's say I have we'll talk about earth only. Let's say we have this, we have earth, and the mass of the earth, because it is very huge, we'll take it as capital M. So this is the earth that we have taken. Now the radius of the earth, let's say it is r. Okay, let's say again we have an object or a ball which is above the surface of earth. This is the object that we have taken, and let's say the distance between this object and the center of earth is small r, and the mass of this object is m. Okay, so this is an ideal condition that we are considering. And after certain time, what will happen? Under free fall. Free fall is what? When the object will come down because of the effect of gravity. What will happen? This ball will come down to the surface of earth. So it will come over here. Okay? Now, according to Newton's law of gravitation, any two objects will have some force of attraction between them. So here the two object is this body and earth, and both are going to experience the force of attraction. Formula says that F equals to GMM by R square. Okay, why I have taken here small r? Because this r should be the distance between these two objects, from the center of these two objects. Okay, now here the ball is a point object as compared to the earth, so I have mentioned it from here. Else you also can take it from the exact center of the ball. So this distance is small r. So let's say this is first equation that we have got. Now under the effect of gravity, when the object will come down to the surface of the earth, what Newton's second law says that F equals to mass into acceleration, because this object is accelerating, it is coming down to the surface of earth. But here, because we are very specific, we are talking about acceleration to gravity, so here I can substitute this value of acceleration by g, and I can call it as acceleration to gravity. So the formula becomes F equals to mg. So this is the second equation that we have got. Now since the body is same in both the situations, actually this is one situation only. In first situation, the object was far away from the earth, and in the second situation, the object has come down to the surface of earth. It means that Newton's law of gravitation and Newton's second law of motion are going to be same. The value of both these forces are going to be same. So I can write it as F1 and F2. What I'm going to do, because these are going to be same, as object is same in both the cases, so I can write it as F1 equals to F2. Now, if I substitute these values over here, F1 is what? It is GMM over R square, and F2 is what? MG. Why I have taken small m over here? Because this small mass is coming under the effect of gravity. Earth is not moving up. What is coming down? Body is coming down. So I have taken small m over here. Now, if these values I have made equivalent, m and m will cancel out each other. And finally, what you are getting is g equals to gm by r square, where g is what? It is the gravitational constant, m is the mass of earth, and r is the distance between the two objects. Now here, nowhere in the formula we have mass of this object which was a small m. It has been cancelled out over here. So that is the reason that this value of g does not depend on the mass. Whether you take a big object or a smaller object, both of the objects are going to come down with the same acceleration, which is 9.8 meter per second square. So if this question comes that how can you prove the value of g does not depend on mass, what you are going to do, you are going to prove it numerically by this way. Cases, the object is farther from the surface of earth, then it falls under the effect of gravity. First universal law of gravitation you will take, then you will take Newton's second law of motion, then you will equate both these, because the object is same, forces are going to be same. After substituting these values over here, you will get formula as g equals to gm by r square, and since nowhere in the formula we have the mass of the object, Therefore, acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of the object. Whether heavier or lighter, both will come down with the same acceleration.